is going on, my Super Sandwiches? Rhymestyle here, and today I bring some good news and some bad news in regards to the most recent costumes to release for DLC 6's free update in Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2. Now, the good news is, with the help of GK45 from the DBXV subreddit, we figured out how to actually obtain these costumes later. Keyword later. The bad news, unfortunately, is they're not implemented in the game yet, meaning you can't actually get them unless you have the PC version of the game and you mod it. Now, as far as PS4 and Xbox One, the bad news is this is not currently available in the game and you can't actually access the feature to unlock these costumes and outfits for your custom created characters. When is it coming out? I have no idea. I'm kind of waiting to hear back from Bandai myself, but I know as much as you guys do, so at this point, all I can say is the second I find out when this patch goes live, I can let you guys know, but for now, all I can tell you is how to get these actual costumes so you can be ready when this update is available in the near future. Now, of course, if you're watching this video in the near future, fingers crossed that it is near future, not distant future, this patch should have already been made available, and at that point, all you gotta do is just do X, Y, and Z to get these costumes, which you can find out in this video. Oh, one last thing before I get into how to unlock the costumes. Android 21. The big question I've been seeing a lot lately in the past week is how to get the Android 21 costume and whether or not it's going to be region locked to Japan only, and unfortunately, it is. So in case you have no idea what I'm talking about, back in V-Jump a couple months ago, I want to say, they announced that if you own both versions of the game, Xenoverse and Fighters, there'll be cross DLC available for free for the players that own both games. For Fighters, you're going to get the Supreme Kai Time Avatar and some stamps, and Xenoverse, you'll be able to get the Android 21 costume. Unfortunately, and I'm hoping that this changes down the line because this costume looks awesome, unfortunately, there's currently no plans to release Android 21 globally. As far as why the decision was made, I have no idea. It has to be something to do with licensing. And again, I hope that they change it down the line. But all I can say is I guess just let Bandai know that you want to see this costume come out because it's kind of unfair. I mean, why does Japan get stuff that we don't? So I don't know. Again, if anything changes, I'll let you guys know down the line. But for now, this is just what we found out. Now, as far as how to get the actual costumes and outfits for cast characters, what you want to do is go to any mentor in the game. Specifically, you want to go to Goku, Whis, Videl, Nappa, Android 18, and whoever else I'm thinking about. Gohan. Basically, the ones I covered in the video. If you choose them as a mentor, you'll have an option to give them a gift. Now, this part is currently disabled in the game, and the way it works is, in the TP Metal Shop right now, you should see that there's an option that says gift, it is grayed out. You'll be able to purchase gifts using TP Metals, and then you can take those exact same gifts over to your mentor, and then give it to them, and then have a chance to get whatever back. Now, unfortunately, RNG is going to decide what you get here, but hopefully you won't be too annoying as far as trying to get that one thing. In the Super Saiyan Rose Awake case, for example, if you want to get that, you want to go to Goku. Go to Goku, set him as your mentor, you're going to have the option to give him a gift, and then you can actually have a chance to get either like a golden outfit, which is the previous raid reward, or the Super Saiyan Rose wig. I also want to point out that this is also how you get the cast character outfits as well, so stuff like the Poopstick Whis, the Journey to the West Goku, the Super Saiyan Hercule Satan. That's how you get those costumes as well. It seems that when you give them the gift the first time, they automatically give you the costume, but I don't know if that's going to change when they actually release it. But after that, every time you give them a gift again, it's going to randomize between stuff like the Super Saiyan Rose wig for Goku, or if you go to Zamasu, you can get the Merged Zamasu outfit, or if you go to Whis, you can also get the Zeno outfit. I do want to point out that the extra costumes are not customizable, so you can't actually go in and change the color outfits for stuff like the Poopstick Whis or the Journey to West Goku, yada yada yada. Those stay the way they are, which kind of sucks, but it is what it is. At least we can customize the basic outfits for now, so baby steps. Something else I want to point out is Nappa's outfit is a wig, so when he goes Super Saiyan, unfortunately the wig pops off, which kind of sucks. I don't know why they did that, and again, I don't know if they're going to choose to change that later, but I also want to point that out before you get the Nappa with the wig and then he goes Super Saiyan and the hair goes away. I mean, as you guys already know, when you transform in this game, based on what headgear you're wearing, it kind of pops off, and the same thing happened with Nappa's hair. Now, something else to point out, in case you didn't notice, along with the brand new outfits, which again consists of the Zeno outfit, the Merged Zamasu outfit, and the Super Saiyan Rose wig, and then anything else I might have missed, you can get old raid rewards this way as well. So stuff that you might have missed in the past, like the golden outfits, the trendy suits. I don't know if they're going to have everything like the Janimba sword, so that's still up in the air, but anything else you might have missed, specifically like the trendy suit or the golden outfits, the golden scouter, you can also obtain these items from your mentors as well. Now, as far as when this is coming out, I have no idea. Again, I want to point that out. I hope it's a lot sooner than later. It kind of sucks that they already announced this and put it in the trailer and everything, and then now we have to wait even longer for them to release it at some point over the next couple weeks. Hopefully a lot sooner, like I said. But the second it comes out, I'll let you guys know, and if you follow me on Twitter at Rhymestyle, I will tweet about the second it's live, so keep an eye out there. Now, of course, if you're on PC, which as you can tell, this is actually PC screenshots in the background, hence the moving tail that that character actually has. You can actually download a mod right now, which unlocks a feature right away, so you'll be able to get all those costumes the second you want. But other than that, for PS4 and Xbox One, unfortunately, you're gonna have to wait a little bit longer. Now, as far as other future updates, I have no idea what else the team has planned for Xenoverse as far as doing like a DLC 7 and an 8. As of right now, there's nothing planned, nothing is announced yet, but the second that changes and they make any kind of news in regards about that, I will let you guys know about that as well. But for now, it's up in the air. But with that said, what is one costume you want to see come out for cast characters and for yourself? Let me know in the comment section below. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day. My name is Rhymestyle, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.